Hello, welcome to the program of EPG Paathshala. Myself, Dr. Sukhneet Suri from University of Delhi. The topic of this module is National Council for Teachers' Education, Structure and Function. The objectives of the module are to know about the changing roles of the National Council for Teachers' Education, to learn the objectives of NCTE, to know the structure, rules and regulations of the council, and to have a bird's eye view of the varied academic functions performed by the council to understand the surveillance and regulatory system of NCTE. The National Council for Teachers' Education, or NCTE, is an apex body of the Government of India, which has the rights and power to develop, implement, and regulate the education system of our country. It works in accordance with the National Council for Teachers' Education Act and the rules, regulations thereof. The history of the National Council dates back to 1973, the year when it was set up as an advisory body to the Government of India. The year 1973 has been a landmark in the annals of teacher education in India when NCTE was established with the help of Ministry of Education, University Grants Commission, and the National Council for Education, Research and Training. The NCTE opened a new era in the field of teacher education and provided opportunities for the proper development of teacher education. It, however, attained the status of statutory body much later, that is, on 17th August 1995, in the pursuance of the National Council for Teachers' Education Act 1993. Professor Nurul Hasan played an instrumental role in the inception of NCTE and was the founder chairperson. The first meeting of NCTE was held on 21st December of the same year and comprised of the following groups: a working group to report on the present status of teacher educators in the country, standing committees on elementary teachers' education, secondary education, higher education, and preschool teacher education, technical, vocational, and work experience education, in-service education, standards in teacher education. Along with the working group and the standing committees, there was also a steering committee. The steering committee was made to coordinate the work of all the standing committees and to highlight the problems which needed the attention of NCTE. The salient recommendations made by these first working groups, standing committees, and the steering committee were that there was an urgent need to set up pace-setting teacher education institutions across our country. They enlisted the minimum mandatory physical facilities which should be provided in teacher training institutions. They also provided methods of organizing academic programs in teacher training institutions, emphasized upon the urgent need to offer courses of studies in the areas such as special education, educational technology, computer education, with special emphasis on practical training, establish a national accrediting agency. They also recommended that internship should be made an essential component in all teacher education programs. They also recommended that the admission to teachers' training institutes in a state should be made on the basis of the entrance tests conducted by the state-level agencies. They established minimum eligibility qualifications of teachers. It was recommended that all organized educational institutions would employ teachers holding degrees which are accredited by the NCTE or by the universities which offer teacher education courses in conformity with the guidelines provided by the NCTE. The experts highlighted the need for outlining all recruitment procedures. They supported the concept of in-service training. The number of teachers to be trained should be fixed by the state governments on the basis of actual recruitment, both subject-wise and seniority-wise. Each teacher should be oriented regarding the educational values in the emerging Indian society. The curricula developed for various programs should be in accordance with the personal and social needs of children, school, and be of relevance to Indian context. Interdisciplinary and integrated approaches should be employed to teacher education. Emphasis should be laid on task-oriented and performance-based teacher education. There should be scope for future development, innovation, and research for growth. Over the years, the scope of NCTE has broadened immensely. While during the formative years, NCTE provided support to center and state government and universities on matters related to teacher education, today it takes policy decisions pertaining to teacher education system in India. And it also provides and supports the surveillance system thereof. Today, NCTE strives to achieve the following objectives: to facilitate planned and coordinated development of the teacher education system throughout the country, to ensure regulation and proper maintenance of norms and standards in the teacher education system and for matters connected therewith, to support the various teacher education programs, and to facilitate research and training of persons for equipping them to teach at pre-primary, primary, secondary, and senior secondary stages in schools, as well as non-formal education, part-time education, adult education, and distance education courses. Let us take a look at the organization structure of NCTE headquarters in New Delhi. NCTE is headed by the chairperson, a vice chairperson, and a member secretary. Deputy secretaries support the work objectives of the member secretary. The total staff strength is about 123. There are 4 regional committees, one each at Jaipur, Bengaluru, Bhubaneswar, and Bhopal. The work of NCTE is conducted through 13 divisions, namely academic, accounts, administration, appeal, coordination, electronic data processing establishment, inspection, legal, regulation, right to information, vigilance, and the VIP division. The council works strictly in accordance with the statutes and ordinances of the National Council for Teachers Education Act. This was formed in December 1993. It led to the establishment of the National Council for Teachers Education with the prime objective of achieving planned and coordinated development of the teacher education system throughout the country, the regulation and proper maintenance of norms and standards in the teacher education system and for matters connected therewith. It came into force in 1993 and was applicable to the whole of India except Jammu and Kashmir. Various rules and regulations have been formed and amended time to time to support the objectives and scope of NCTE. The salient rules and regulations include the National Council for Teachers Education Rules 1997, which have been amended several times, such as in 2000, 2003, and 2011. The 3 National Council for Teachers Education regulations, namely assignment of functions and powers to the executive committee, procedures relating to the meetings of the council and quorum for such meetings, matters relating to the quorum, co-option, and meetings of the executive committee. NCTE regulations pertaining to the organization and functioning of regional committees, amended several times, such as in 1995, 2002, 2003, and in 2011. NCTE regulations regarding recognition norms and procedures, 2005. Guidelines for regulation of tuition fees and other fees chargeable by unaided teacher education institutions. Determination of minimum qualification for recruitment of teachers in schools. Let us now take a look at the wide spectrum of functions performed by NCTE. It undertakes surveys and studies relating to various aspects of teacher education and publish the results thereof. Make recommendations to the central and state governments, universities, University Grants Commission, and recognized institutions in the matter of preparation of suitable plans and programs in the field of teacher education. It also coordinates and monitors teacher education and its development in the country. NCTE lays down guidelines in respect of minimum qualifications for a person to be employed as a teacher in schools or in recognized institutions, lays down norms for any specified category of courses or trainings in teacher education, including the minimum eligibility criteria for admission thereof, and the method of selection of candidates, duration of the various courses, their contents, and the mode of curriculum. It lays down guidelines for compliance by recognized institutions for starting new courses or training, and for providing physical and instructional facilities, staffing pattern, and staff qualifications. Lays down standards in respect of examination leading to teacher education qualifications, criteria for admissions to such examinations, and schemes of courses or training. It also lays down guidelines regarding tuition fees and other fees chargeable by the recognized institutions, promotes and conducts innovations and research in various areas of teacher education, and disseminates the results thereof. The Council periodically examines and reviews the implementation of the norms, guidelines, and standards laid down by itself, and suitably advises the recognized institutions. It has evolved suitable performance appraisal system, norms, and mechanisms for enforcing accountability of recognized institutions, formulate schemes for various levels of teacher education, and identify recognized institutions and set up new institutions for teacher development programs. Take all necessary steps to prevent commercialization of teacher education. Perform such other functions as may be entrusted to it by the central government. The academic activities of the council are performed by the academic division in support with academic experts all over the country. The salient academic activities performed include: coordinate the academic activities related to teacher education programs by supporting standing committee in the review and development of various norms, standards relating to each program. Develop, evaluate, and review various policies on teacher education, curricular framework, and model syllabi. Prepare code of professional ethics and performance standards for conducting academic activities in various teacher education institutions. Conduct surveys, develop database, and help committees to reach a research-based decision. Develop resource support in the era of teacher education, such as through the development and publication of monographs, journals, and e-resources. Coordinate with the state governments, UGC, universities, and other affiliating bodies. Develop guidelines for teacher education test. State governments conduct TETs while CBSE conducts the CTET. The NCTE has a strong surveillance and regulatory system, which is implemented through the coordinated efforts of various divisions, especially the regulatory division, legal division, inspection division, and the vigilance division. They formulate regulations and maintain highest possible quality standards of various teacher education institutions and programs, ensure implementation of the norms and standards laid down, conduct inspections, identify deficiencies, and give an opportunity to improve the education system in various teacher training institutions, eliminate or minimize the scope of malpractice by detecting points of system failure. NCTE thus functions on the principles of total quality management. In view of the large number of teacher training programs being held in various teacher training institutions across India, it becomes vital for the National Council to remain abreast with the challenges it faces in the implementation of its norms. It performs a number of regulatory functions as well, the salient ones being: formulate norms and regulations for teacher education institution and teacher education programs, formulate minimum recruitment qualifications for school teachers, review and amend NCTE Act rules and regulations therein, conduct sensitization programs, facilitate training of untrained school teachers, invite and process applications for new and existing teacher education institutions. The Section 13 of National Council for Teachers Education Act 1993 empowers the council to cause inspection of the recognized teacher education institutions so as to find out if they are functioning in accordance with the regulations, norms and standards prescribed by the NCTE for the teacher education programs to be conducted in a particular teacher education institution. The inspection division has developed an inspection manual. It conducts inspections once in 3 to 5 years of each recognized teacher education institution. It also prescribes procedure for conducting inspections, which we will discuss shortly. Conduct special inspections and as and when suggested by higher authorities. Now let us take a closer look at the process of inspection prescribed by the National Council. The process begins with the selection of institutions to be inspected and the members of the visiting team. The institutions to be inspected are suitably informed and the inspection is conducted as per the specifications given in the inspection manual. The submitted reports are carefully analyzed for identifying deficiencies or errors in the inspected system. The inspected institution is informed about the discrepancies, if any, and given a chance to improve the system in a stipulated period of time. The compliance report is thereafter examined by the experts. It is thus an ongoing process and an important aspect of the surveillance system. A wide spectrum of programs are currently being recognized by NCTE. These include diploma and bachelor's program in education, such as the diploma in preschool education, diploma in elementary teacher education, bachelor's of elementary education, bachelor's of education, and the master's of education. Programs in physical education include diploma in physical education, bachelor's of physical education, master's of physical education. There are open and distance learning programs also, which include diploma in elementary education, bachelor's in education, programs in arts, such as diploma in visual arts, diploma in performing arts. The latest development in the National Council for Teachers Education is the 2014 regulations, which are the outcome of the Justice Verma Commission, which had been appointed by the Honorable Supreme Court of India. Based on its recommendations, the NCTE currently recognizes 15 programs in education, which have been discussed just now. The Council has also introduced 3 new programs: 4-year BA, BSc B.Ed, 3-year B.Ed part-time, and 3-year B.Ed M.Ed. Duration of B.Ed, Bachelor's of Physical Education, and Master's of Education has been increased to 2 years. Teacher education programs would now be established in composite multidisciplinary institutions and not in standalone teacher education institutions. Each teacher education program would now comprise of 3 components: theory, practicum, and internship. It must be ensured during the preparation of curriculum that it provides at least 25% of weightage to school-based activities and internship. Information, communication and technology, yoga, gender and disability or inclusive education would now be an integral part of curriculum. M.Ed programs should have specialization such as in elementary, secondary, senior secondary education. Open and distance learning programs should be made more rigorous and their quality should be improved. Higher education opportunities should be provided for in-service teachers, such as diploma in elementary education, bachelor's in education, by giving duty leave to the teachers, and bachelor's of education part-time. Compulsory accreditation at least once in every 5 years by a NCTE-recognized agency, such as NAC. Today, the National Council for Teachers Education is a little more than 4 decades old. It is a young, energetic body which has contributed and accomplished a lot in the field of teachers' education. The journey of NCTE has been tough and eventful. The work carried out by NCTE makes us feel its ubiquitous presence across India. Yet, with changing times, newer challenges and achievements shall adorn the council. I would like to conclude by saying, we need good teachers to light the flame of a child's creative expression. We need the magic of teachers to inspire our children to discover their own genius. And NCTE is leaving no stone unturned to help India realize such wishes and dreams. Thank you, all the best.